I wanted the fame, but not the cover of Newsweek. Oh well, guess beggars can't be choosy. Wanted to receive attention from my music. Wanted to be left alone in public, excuse me. But wanting my cake and eat it too, and wanting it both ways. Fame made me a balloon, cause my ego inflated when I flew. See, but it was confusing, cause all I wanted to do is be the Bruce Lee of loosely abused ink. Use it as a tune when I blew steam. Woo! Hit the lottery, ooh wee. But with what I gave up to get, it was bittersweet. It was like winning a used me. Ironic, cause I think I'm getting so huge I need a shrink. I'm beginning to lose sleep. One sheep, two sheep, going cuckoo and kooky is cool key. But I'm actually weirder than you think, cause I'm
friends with the mom. much of a poet, but I know somebody once told me to seize the moment and don't squander it. Cause you never know when it all could be over tomorrow, so I keep conjuring. Sometimes I wonder where these thoughts spawn from.
Yeah, ponder it, do you wonder? No wonder you're losing your mind the way it wanders.
I think you've been wandering off down yonder and stumbled on to Jeff Van Vondren. Cause I need an interventionist to intervene between me and this monster and save me from myself and all this conflict. Cause of everything that I love killing me and I can't conquer it. My OCD's talking me in the head, keep knocking.
That's exactly what I need. That's all. All right, ready? These always awkward moments in between.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to the Rochester Razor Sharks Broadcast Network. Tariq Spence here with you with John Boone as we get ready to call the start of the brand new season in the Premier Basketball League for the returning champion, Rochester Razor Sharks. John, tonight, the Razor Sharks are back in the building again here at the Blue Cross Arena, and a lot of familiar faces from last year.
Yeah, with 8 returning players, this team is, you know, really looking forward to playing again, and 4 new players, they've got a lot to go out and play for.
Well, tonight they take on Cheektowaga. Now, Cheektowaga is a tough team. They came in last year always wanting to do their best against the Razor Sharks. Razor Sharks have basically manhandled them. But this is a night, New Year's Eve, where they definitely want to get a win against Rochester to start off their season.
Yeah, they'll try. I think they're going to have some problems with Rochester's size. The Razor Sharks got a lot of depth. They're excited to play, too. So I think it's going to be a tough task for Cheektowaga tonight.
Well, we'll see what happens. Join us at a tip-off and the raising of the banner for the 2016 Rochester Razor Sharks, trying to do the same exact thing in 2017, bring a championship. Tip-off's coming up next here on the Rochester Razor Sharks Broadcast Network. Sharks Broadcast Network. Tariq Spence here with you with John Boone as we get ready to call the start of the brand new season in the Premier Basketball League for the returning champion, Rochester Razor Sharks. John, tonight, the Razor Sharks back in the building again here at the Blue Cross Arena, and a lot of familiar faces from last year.
Yeah, with 8.
Okay.
tonight, I'm sorry. Rolling, 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 rolling. How many more shots until you're rolling? We just need a face to face. You could pick the time and the place. You'll spend some time away. Now you need to forward and give me all the work, 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 work.
It's send me out there, work, 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 work. You see me do my da, 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 da. Something about that, wah, 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 wah. When you walk out, la, 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 la. When the cash from my turn, 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 turn.
2. Happy New Year, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Dino K from Fickle 93.3, and welcome to the Blue Cross Arena at the War Memorial. Tonight's New Year's Eve home opener with your 2016 PBL World Champion Rochester Razor Sharks as they take on the Chautauqua Hurricanes. Ladies and gentlemen, the ushers and security staff on duty tonight have been asked to enforce the following rules. The Razor Sharks ask for your cooperation. There will be no standing in the aisles while the game is in progress. The Blue Cross Arena is a smoke-free facility. A smoking area is available off the upper atrium near Broad Street. The use of alcoholic beverages not legally sold within the arena and the throwing of any objects on the court or the use of obscene language is strictly prohibited. Persons violating these rules will be subject to immediate ejection from the arena and may face penalty, fine, or arrest that may be provided by law. The Razor Sharks and the staff of the Blue Cross Arena ask for your cooperation with the ushers and security staff in enforcement of these rules and sincerely hope that you enjoy tonight's game. And now, please welcome to the court your 2017 Rochester Lady Sharks. Joining the Lady Sharks, let's hear it for Finley!
Turn down for what? Turn down for what? Turn down for what? Turn down for what? Turn down for what?
Let's first introduce the visiting team, the Chautauqua Hurricane. Starting at forward, 6'6" from Fitchburg State, number 33, Maurice Green. A forward, 6'6" from Montgomery Community College, number 34, Travonta Gatewood. Guard forward, 6'6" from Siena College, number 50, Edwin Ubiles. And a guard from Payne State, 6'6", number 6, Gino Green. And a guard from Monroe Community College, 6'3", Marcus Fegan. And the head coach of the Hurricane, Jerome Moore.
Championship Series, the Razor Sharks held a 1-0 lead over the Lake Michigan Admirals. With a win at home, the Sharks would take home their third straight league title. Lake Michigan got out to an early lead, extending into the second quarter. But Rochester closed the gap and entered halftime deadlocked with the Admirals at 40-40. After a tight third quarter, the game was winding down fast, with neither team able to take a comfortable lead. With a minute to go in the fourth, the Razor Sharks took a lead with a three-pointer. A crazy home stretch that included a technical foul and missed free throws by both teams led to a 93-92 Sharks lead with only seconds remaining. Lake Michigan had one final opportunity to get a shot off at the buzzer, but it's blocked by Rochester, giving them the victory. The Razor Sharks were PBL three-peat champions.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's meet the entire roster for the 2017 Rochester Razor Sharks. 6'2" from Sam Houston State, number 2, Corey Allman. 6'1" from Texas Southern, number 25, Deverell Biggs. 6'8" from Louisville, number 32, Josh Chichester. 6'10" from St. John's, number 44, Dallin Coker. 6'3" from Robert Morris, number 11, Melvin Council. Out of Tennessee Chattanooga, number 4, Therese Crouch. 6'6" from West Virginia State, number 12, James Helton. 6'6" from Lewis, number 33, Sydney Holmes. 6'1" from Brockport, number 5, John Ivy. 6'5" from Southern Mississippi, number 10, Rashard McGill. From Washington State, a 7-footer, number 14, Jordan Rayleigh. And 6'11" from Tennessee, number 35, Dominic Woodson. Director of Basketball Operations, Matt Cahill. Equipment Manager, Rob Richards. Trainer, Kathy Fabrizio. Assistant Coach, Clay Pitnero. Assistant Coach, Jason Sutter. And your head coach of the Rochester Razor Sharks, Chris Iverson. Ladies and gentlemen, we ask for your attention to the court for the raising of the 2016 championship banner. On the court for this special presentation are some of the players and the owners, Dr. Sev Hrivnak, Paul Rosen, and Lawrence Maroney, along with players Corey Allman, Jerice Crouch, Josh Chichester, Melvin Council, Sydney Holmes, Dally Coker, and James Helton. Make room for another one.
We are the champions. We are the champions. Who time for losers? 'Cause we
And now, ladies and gentlemen, rendering tonight's military honors are four members from the Coast Guard station here in Rochester.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to the Rochester Razor Sharks Broadcast Network. Tariq Spence here with you with John Boone as we get ready to call the start of the brand new season in the Premier Basketball League for the returning champion, Rochester Razor Sharks. John, tonight,
fans of the Razor Sharks,
the Razor Sharks
know
Sharks
the 2016.
Are back in the building again here at the Blue Cross Arena, and a lot of familiar faces from last year.
Yeah, with eight returning players, this team is, you know, really looking forward to playing again, and four new players, they've got a lot to go out and play for.
Well, tonight they take on Cheektowaga. Now, Cheektowaga is a tough team. They came in last year always wanting to do their best against the Razor Sharks. Razor Sharks have basically manhandled them. But this is a night, New Year's Eve, where they definitely want to get a win against Rochester to start off their season.
Yeah, they'll try. I think they're going to have some problems with Rochester's size. The Razor Sharks got a lot of depth. They're excited to play, too. So I think it's going to be a tough task for Cheektowaga tonight.
Well, we'll see what happens. Join us at a tip-off and the raising of the banner for the 2016 Rochester Razor Sharks, trying to do the same exact thing in 2017, bring a championship. Tip-off's coming up next here on the Rochester Razor Sharks Broadcast Network.
Does that star-spangled banner wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Thank you, Bailey Morrison.
And we are live here at the Blue Cross Arena after a very well-performed national anthem. Tariq Spence with you, John Boone, as we start off the 2016, I guess, last game of 2016 before we start 2017 officially on this New Year's Eve game. John, tonight the Razor Sharks taking on the Hurricane, and good to have you with you here today. Good to meet you, good to talk to you, and glad you can make it in for tonight's game.
Glad to be here.
A lot going on today. Now, you were in practice yesterday.
Yes.
As they do a ceremonial tip-off. But you were at practice yesterday. What was your sort of feel from this team? We mentioned it in the opener, about eight returning guys to the roster, which means some new guys, some young guys. Jarice Crouch, no longer the young player. He's the vet of the team. But what was your sort of feeling watching practice yesterday for this Razor Shark team trying to win another championship?
They're anxious. You can always tell that first game, especially when you got a group that's a veteran group. They are, you know, excited to play again, and they're anxious to get out and play and stop beating on each other.
Well, it's interesting. I saw a testy practice when I went, and you know, guys trying to compete too during the season to try to get this team right. I talked with Coach Iverson before the game and get this sort of sense of him running the show last year. You might not have known this, but a lot of people may not know there was a bit of a coaching change in the beginning of the season last year. Chris Iverson came in, brought a championship, played the rest of the way, coached the rest of the way, did a great job in bringing another championship to the organization.
But this time around, he's getting it all from scratch. He's getting his guys in, a lot of returning guys from last year, a lot of guys he's very familiar with, Jerese Crouch, Corey Allman, who've helped put some banners here at the Blue Cross Arena. But it's got to feel good that you know at least 8 of these guys on the team know each other extremely well, John.
Well, without a doubt. And Chris has his mark on this franchise. He's been here a while. He knows exactly what he wants to do. And he's been able to do that on his own this time without having to get input from others.
So it should be a pretty good game here today. Meanwhile, the Hurricane getting ready to come in. Now, they used to be Erie, but they're pronounced, how do you say it, John? What is
Chautauqua.
Chautauqua. So they used to be Erie. So the Erie Hurricane, now Chautauqua Hurricane. And so they are ready to meet at midcourt. So the start of the 2017 official season for the Razor Sharks will start with the last day in 2016. And tip-off will begin now with Riley tipping it off and over, and Chautauqua will take control. The Hurricane get first possession. Nice man crowd on hand.
Man-to-man defense for the Razor Sharks.
Moving the ball around. Dele Coker. Helton. Last minute pass. Off glass. No good. Rebounded by Coker. And back up the court come the Razor Sharks. So the Hurricane has a chance to get on the board first. Nice ball movement from the Hurricane.
They're going to need that because they're not going to be able to get a lot at the basket, so they're going to have to try to create a lot with good ball movement.
Crouch running the point with Allman as his shooting guard. Coker down low to Riley. Nice pass. Oh, reverse layup. Can't get it to go as it bounces out of the rim. Allman couldn't get it to go down. One of the leading scorers last year was number 2, Corey Allman for Rochester. Jumper no good. So neither team able to get onto the board here thus far. Kind of a lid on that rim.
A little first game jitters. Got to just work through the excitement of the opening of the season.
Coker spinning off the back iron. That doesn't go. Back up the court come the Hurricane.
It's funny, in practice the other day, guys were missing layups, and Coach Iverson was like, you're going to see a lot of those in the first game.
Down low, reverse layup. That doesn't go. Rebound, put back, blocked. Picked up by Rochester, back up the court. Still no score here. Allman for 3, thought about it. Helton corner. That's no good. Tipped away, Coker offensive rebound. Boy, I'm not usually used to this. Jerese Crouch for 3. That's no good. Helton rebound. Hurricane got to hit those boards.
Again, the size of the Razor Sharks is going to be a problem for Chautauqua all night.
Working it down low. Are we getting on the board? We are. Finally.
Jordan Rainey, a former D-League player. Got a lot of talent for a big guy.
Rainey, described as some of his coaches, a very good passer for a big man.
Yeah, loves to look for cutters off of screens.
Game tied at 2, just underway here. The Premier Basketball League, they score in bunches, John. If you've never seen a game before and you watch it for the first time on ESPN3, the foul call there. That's going to be on Green. But you'll see a lot of scoring in bunches. Normally, it doesn't take this long for a team to get on the board.
Like I said, the first game, you're always a little amped up, and the easy shots aren't always so easy to start.
Now, I know, John, you've coached for many years. Your thoughts on that first game of the first season after you've sort of break in camp and your team is set. What is sort of the mindset and the thought process when you finally get these guys who have been beating up on each other for the last 3-4 weeks out against a new fresh opponent?
Yeah, you just try to get through that adrenaline rush, like the first 6 minutes of the quarter, and then hopefully guys start to settle in and start to get their game legs. Because of the excitement, they're going to get tired quick. But then they just got to work through that, and they'll settle down, and the game will start to come to them, and you'll start to see what they're used to doing come more naturally.
Coker's second shot is no good. That's tipped in. Is Helton going to get that? I believe so. So we'll see how they score, but that was a tip-in score. Rochester up by 3. the defense.
That's the other thing early. You want to try get your feet moving on defense, try to maybe create some turnovers and get some easy baskets going the other way.
In and out, no good. Jumper put back is no good. Boy, Hurricane having a tough time with it. Off glass, they can't get it. Go tip in is good. Finally.
A concern by Coach Iverson the other day in practice was rebounding. Even with their size, guys were relying too much on their size and not actually putting a body on somebody. We saw that there.
Rare miss by Corey Ullman back the other way. Come the Hurricane. Billis with it and dribble it out. Back over to the top of the key slowly. Eight on the shot clock. Around the rim and in. Backboard move. Nice play. Quickly up the court. Ullman for three. Don't leave him open too often. Doesn't miss too many in a row.
No. He'll get it going here.
6-5. Low scoring affair first quarter. 8-10 left to go. That's no good. Put back no good. It's just darting off the hands of players. Ends up in Crouch's hands. Alley to the hoop. Finished by James Helton. Rochester up by one.
Transition baskets always get your feet moving a little bit quicker.
Left wing. Set up a pick. I'm not even sure if they're running a play here. If it's just one-on-one. Down low, knocked away, and a foul called. And will it be the big man?
Yes, Jordan came over a little too much there. All he had to do was just stand there with his hands up.
7:39 left to go here in this first quarter. Rochester, 1-point lead. Refs want to take a second here to get something straight. All right, I got that situated. I don't know what it was. But, but we're back to playing ball. Yabilis behind the back trying to finish. Gets his own rebound after being blocked. Put back is good.
He was a big-time scorer at Siena, and you can see why with moves like that.
Very good ball handler. Crouch with it. Draws him on defense. Ullman for three. Straight up, straight down. Corey Ullman from outside.
Again, working through those jitters now, you can see he's a little bit more relaxed on that jump shot.
7 minutes left to go, first quarter. Rochester with a two-point lead. Hurricane moving the ball around, sharing it. Up, blocked by Coker. Rebound, knocked away. Out of bounds. And it will be Hurricane ball.
Coker made a nice block there, just couldn't grab the ball.
A lot of people on hand for the first game of the year, including the King, in the building here at the Blue Cross Arena. And so they got to fix the net.
Little issue with the net
there.
Yeah,
it's always don't want to present any problems. Coming up at halftime, we'll talk to Dr. Sev Herbniak, who is the man running the Rochester Razor Sharks Premier Basketball League.
Didn't back talk door. On defense there. Nice slip screen.
Didn't hurt him. Back the other way. Corey Ullman can hurt you. Can't hit that three, though. Tipped away. Helton fights for it. Gets it back. Crouch driving towards the hole. Dishes back out. Swings it around. Helton attacking. Turns. Coker. Pull-up jumper. No good.
Nobody there for an offensive rebound. Five guys on the perimeter.
6:20 left to go here first quarter. Rochester only up by two. Tip. Pull-up jumper. No good front rim. Both teams having some trouble offensively. Crouch, Coker, off glass and in for two.
Fast break points, transition points. You love to see them, especially early in the game.
You know, for a team that's not shooting that well and the Hurricane are not shooting that well, how do you sort of break out of this? I mean, it's not as if they're in a deep hole here. Rochester hasn't shot well either. Do you keep driving and keep shooting? What do you do?
Yeah, you just keep trying to run your offense. I don't think you can really run with the Razor Sharks.
Oh. Well, a nice pass there by Fegan. Put up is in for two. So that's four quick points. Green with the jumper. And then Fegan with the steal and two. So just like that, we have a tie game at 12.
Sloppy play on that end.
With 5:19 left to go here in this first quarter. Post-up move blocked there by Green. Back up the court from the Hurricane. Up foul, and they're going to get Ubilis, I believe so. And that is going to be a timeout. We'll take one as well. So 5:05 left to go here in this first quarter. Rochester Razor Sharks and the Hurricane tied at 12 here on the Rochester Razor Sharks Broadcast Network on ESPN3.
Streaming.
Back here live in the Blue Cross Arena, game tied at 12, 5:05 left to go here, first quarter. Tariq Spence, Sean Boone with you here as we call the first game of the season in 2017 on this last day of 2016 as the Razor Sharks put another banner up at the Blue Cross Arena, the trophies sitting there from 2014, 2015, and 2016, trying to put another one up there for 2017. But the Hurricane coming out here, firing on all cylinders as well. Off the back iron rebound. Crouch for three. That's no good. And save, nope, out of bounds. It'll be Razor Sharks. No. Kane basketball. Okay.
Looks like it was touched there.
Yeah, that's certainly a way
by
to go.
Fegan.
Yeah. Back up the court. Taquan Strowman up. He stepped out of bounds, so they call that. You're going to see Melvin Council come in for Jarice Crouch. Oh, I'm sorry, for James Helton. So, oh, well, now Melvin's going to have to wait. I've never understood that, why the refs won't let them make the stuff. I can't understand.
I don't know either.
He's halfway on the court. You have an inbound the ball. It's
a control thing, I think.
I guess so.
Nice move by Raley.
So Raley, Jordan Raley with the turnaround. A lot of weapons for him. I've seen a lot of up and under, a lot of turnaround shots.
He's the first D-League player to actually be playing for the Razor Sharks. He has a lot of tools, and he was successful in the D-League.
Well, I have to say, I've seen him in practice, very smooth, relaxed. You know, a lot of bigs sometimes, nothing against bigs, I don't want to start a problem with bigs, but they're not the best passers, they're not the best at handling the rock.
Well, he's very comfortable with the basketball in his hands.
That ball blocked there by Council. Fegan gets it again. Put back is good. A lot of opportunities for the Hurricane.
Yeah, they're crashing the boards. Taking advantage of guys not putting a body on somebody.
Crouch to Chichester. He gets it up. No good. Oh, they do pull a foul. So I don't know if the ref uses whistle. They stop play. It's fine. tied at 14, and Josh Chichester will head to the free throw line.
Nice entry pass there over the defense.
It's such a time warp to see Jarese Crouch, who was a rookie, starting with the Razor Sharks. And he's played with a number of other teams outside of the season for Rochester, to now walk over and talk to Chris Iverson, once assistant coach, now head coach. And, you know, it's just a very weird combination.
It's weird for me, too. I saw him when he was in high school, at Henniger High School in Syracuse.
Yeah. I tell you, and it's just these two have been together at the hip in the entire career for Jarese Crouch with the Premier Basketball League and the Razor Sharks. Really, rebound. And it's a foul before the pass. And that's Chichester and Fegan getting tangled.
Hurricane foul, 24.
Oh, nope. It was Barry. So, his body's getting tangled up there. Omen for three, thought about it, tried to get it down low to Chichester. Stolen away. Barry's jumper, soft touch, no good. Rebound by Fegan. Nobody's boxing out.
No box out. Again. Chautauqua just crashing every time a shot goes up because no one's putting a body on him.
Steal there by Chautauqua. Now try to set things up here. Game tied at 16 for the Hurricane, and not sure what that was. Is away from the ball.
Illegal defense call on Raley. He was standing in the lane too long.
So that'll be a free throw. And Taquan Stroman will take it. That's no good. So game still tied at 16. And these two teams, you know, not a very well shot game, John.
No, teams are about as cold as it is outside.
Yeah, it's very much so. Jumper by Barry's no good. That was an ugly shot and had no intentions of going down. And with 3:01 left to go here in this first quarter, more subs for the Hurricane.
And I think not getting those rebounds, you can't get in transition and get the easy baskets that you like. And Chautauqua's really, you know, making this a half-court game.
Council off the dribble, blocked from behind. Are they going to call a foul? That's going to be on Barry. Yep. So it's Ruben Barry. And so they'll take a timeout. So 2:50 left to go here first quarter. Game tied at 16. Not exactly an offensive show just yet. We'll have more of the first quarter coming up next. You're the Rochester Razor Sharks Broadcast Network.
Hey, everybody. Welcome back to the Rochester Razor Sharks Broadcast Network. Game tied at 16 between the Hurricane and the Razor Sharks. And Tariq Spence, John Boone with you here today as we have the first regular season game for Rochester. They hung up their banner today for 2016, trying to add another one for 2017. Three in a row, the last 3 years, the Razor Sharks have won the Premier Basketball League Championship. Just would be a fourth year if they can get there. But this Hurricane team has always had a tough time against Rochester. And it seems as if this year, or maybe it's just this game or whatever it may be, they come out looking good today.
I think it's a combination of the Razor Sharks being a little flat and Chautauqua being a little hyped up from the fact that they haven't been playing well against this team.
Well, for the Razor Sharks, they have been looking forward to this to start the season. And every year, some of the teams that aren't that good, to be honest with you, John, get a little bit better and closer to the competition. And, you know, the team you want to beat in the Premier Basketball League are the Razor Sharks. Kentucky Mavericks are another good team.
Yep.
Jamestown is a very good team, you know.
Oh, it's a lot easier for them to get up for you than sometimes for the Razor Sharks to get up for their opponents.
Yeah, absolutely. We shall see what happens here. Swinging that ball around are the Hurricane. Tipped away, good defense there. Jarese Crouch on the press over to Corey Allman for three. Bang. Corey Allman, don't let him get comfortable around the three-point line.
Great three in transition.
Scoop layup, no good. Tipped away, picked up by Corey Allman on the break. And foul there. And tried to get the ball to Riley, and he went straight up with it, just got hacked on the arm.
Again, good defense at the other end leads to transition opportunity and a couple free throws here.
So Jordan at the free throw line. Rochester up now by six. That's how quickly it can start for you. The Hurricane having a really tough time keeping that offense consistent. They've been a lot of scrappy points.
Yeah, again, it started at the defensive end. They picked it up a little bit.
So Rochester extends their lead out to seven. Some substitutions for Rochester coming in. Stroman's jumper is good from outside. Jarese Crouch pressing straight to the hole and in for two. So Jarese Crouch accelerating. That's the one thing about Jarese. He can go, as I nicknamed him, 0 to 60 very fast. And if he needs to accelerate, don't get behind him.
Yeah, he's got a different speed than a lot of us.
It's a speed of, the speed of the game. I know as you as a coach have seen that before, where a guy seems like he's running faster than everybody, and then he goes a little bit faster.
Yeah. Makes it hard to defend when they got that extra gear.
124 left to go here in this first quarter. First free throw by Stroman is good. John Ivey now checking in for the Razor Sharks. Ivey from school I spent 4 years at. Four good years at Brockport. From that program and, of course, from the Rochester area. Now playing for the Rochester Razor Sharks.
Good to see local be able to get on the floor and hopefully make some nice contributions here for the Razor Sharks.
Council down low to Woodson. Working hard. Turnaround jumper's no good. Knocked away. Hurricane with it. Pass. Stroman driving. They don't stop ball. Swings it around. Three. Corner. That's no good. Rebound put back is.
Again, another offensive rebound. They got to work on putting a body on somebody when a shot goes up.
Ivy with it. Swings it over. Council will try a three. That's no good. Rebounded. Hurricane back up the court. They run. Down by three. Giving the ball Fegan.
lost it out of bounds. So with 40 seconds left to go, 3-point lead for Rochester. And the Hurricane will maintain possession. I thought that was off Fegan, but it wasn't. Swings it back out. Spinning the lane, off glass, no good. Chichester with the rebound. Up the court comes Council. Ullman for three. Off the side of the rim, and that'll go out of bounds. Remains Rochester basketball.
Chautauqua doing a good job of trying to find some mismatches with the Razor Sharks bigs and then just isolating them and trying to get at the basket.
So they're running a play. And as Coach Iverson sends it in, says run the horns, whatever that play is.
Backdoor cut. Oh, he didn't go.
Yep. Ivy will hold on. They turn off the shot clock. 16. He drives underneath the hoop. Council thought about it. Back down low. Chichester.
Great pass.
With 12 seconds left to go, Rochester up by five. 9 seconds. Stripped away. Picked up. Out of bounds. 3.9 left to go here in the first quarter. Rochester up by five. Hurricane going to have to inbounds this quick. Great play here. Council right back down low to Chichester. In for two.
Defender got caught sneaking down the court there. And Melvin made him pay for it.
Corey got aggressive on the defense. Hit the arm of Fegan, and he'll head to the free throw line.
Not a smart foul there in the last few seconds.
3.2 left to go here in the first quarter. And see if Marcus Fegan can make Rochester pay for it. He does. Cut that lead now.
Fegan, another guy who played locally at Monroe Community College.
Second free throw is good, so he nails both of them. 3.2 left to go. See if Corey can heave this at half court. Nope, that's not going to do it. They're going to let it go. It looks like they are. So that's the end of the first quarter. Rochester up by three, 27-24. The Razor Sharks will go to his second quarter against the Hurricane. Coming up next here on the Rochester Razor Sharks Broadcast Network.
Back here live at the Blue Cross Arena, Rochester up by three, 27-24. Getting ready to start the second quarter. The premier basketball champion, Rochester Razor Sharks, put the banner up earlier on before starting the game today. But coming out and seeing the Hurricane team, a little feisty.
very feisty. 13 offensive rebounds in that first quarter. Just tells you that they're playing a little bit quicker than the Razor Sharks are.
No need to dwell on the shooting percentages for both teams. They were not good.
No, not very good at all.
Ivy, step back jumper, no good. Put back by Woodson is good.
Woodson, a former big-time high school recruit, went to Memphis.
Spent some time there, and I think Tennessee spent some time there, and now in the Premier Basketball League. Melissa inbound, gets it to Stroman. Ivy with him defensively, sticking with him, pick set left. Jumper, no good, Council with the rebound.
Good contest by Woodson.
Ivy, pull up jumper, is good. John Ivy from outside, and he gets a nice round of applause from the Razor Shark fans. Down low Green, back out. Ubilis with it. Digs all over him. That would have been impressive had it gone down, but it didn't. Rebound and put back. A lot of second again, shot opportunities.
Another offensive rebound. Every time a shot goes up, Chautauqua just crashing with four guys.
Ivy. Dribble. Trying to drive by. Step back. Woodson had it off the fingertips. It'll be a backcourt. Better a backcourt than a easy lay-in for two.
And John trying to do a little too much there.
And a five-point lead for Rochester. Chautauqua with it now. Ubilis pick set, trying to go around it. Great pass. Reverse layup looked good, but it just didn't go down. Woodson thunders through. Scoop layup and good.
That's a big man there. They're going to bounce off of him if you get in his way.
He glides, though. He's a big guy, but he glides towards the hole. Most big guys want to just throw it down every single time. Billis had it knocked away by Diggs. Put back is good. So they're staying with it. John, you mentioned this earlier, the fact that Hurricane just crashed those boards.
Every time a shot is missed, it seems like Chautauqua ends up with it, or at least getting their hands on it, which slowing down any type of transition game that the Razor Sharks want to try to get into.
Five-point lead for Rochester. Ivy, who you'll see here on the replay why he's going to the free throw line, striving over the hole. He's hacked. So with 9:49 left to go here in the first half, John Ivy hits his first free throw. Sydney Holmes will check in for Josh Chichester. Back into the game now.
Every time they start to push the lead out a little bit, Chautauqua seems to have an answer. Let's see what happens here if John can get him back up seven.
Off to the rebound, shot ball. Rebound. Pull-up jumper, Biggs. No good. Rebound to Chautauqua. So back up the court they go. Swinging it around. 6-point lead for Rochester. Foul call. They're either going to get Woodson or Ivy. And it looks like it's going to be
an Ivy.
Ivy.
Rochester's foul at the time. John Ivy. Still line for the Hurricane.
So Green will head to the free throw line. And when these games get to this point, Coach, right now you're at this sort of stagnant point between the two teams. Chautauqua, they come back. Razor Sharks take a lead. At this particular moment, as people start getting ready for New Year's already, charged up with a few hours to go, you want to get your team going before the Razor Sharks start running. They have the lead.
Right.
So you don't want them to continue to start mounting on you. Rebounding would help.
Yes. And it's really the key. I mean, when they rebound, you know, they can get out and run, and when they can't, the half-court game is more to Chautauqua's liking.
Ivy, three, good. John Ivy. It's got to feel good to play that well so far in front of your home crowd. Just getting a little bit more comfortable for number five.
I'm sure this isn't the first game he's played in here.
Yeah. Quade played quite a few games in high school. And at 8:51 left to go here in the first half, Rochester has pulled out to a 9-point lead, 37-28. We'll be back with more first half action coming up next on the Rochester Razor Sharks Broadcast Network. Back here live at the Blue Cross Arena, Rochester Razor Sharks up by 9, 37-28. Tariq Spence, John Boone with you here today as we call the first game of the regular season. I love these New Year's Eve games because you get a chance to not only start the season, but, you know, everybody wants to, you know, find a way to get out and do something before they head to wherever they're going for the ball to drop, whether it's a party or family or out in Rochester, they're going to have fireworks right after the game.
Yes.
So
planning on going over to watch it.
Yeah, should be fun as always. Cold, but it'll be fun.
It's January in Rochester.
Yep. We've had some pretty decent weather though.
I can't.
You know, we've had our cold days, but we've had our unseasonably 40s, 50s too.
Violation.
So 8:50 left to go, and a Lion violation will put Green back at the line. So Gino will get another chance.
Green gets another shot.
Is that them?
Yeah.
Second free throw is good, so Razor Sharks going to have to pay for that one. 8-point lead, though. Ivy swings it around. Biggs. Ivy thought about it again. Swings it around. There's a foul away from the ball. That's going to be, I believe, on Green.
Illegal defense call again.
And you always tell who it is because the guy just puts his head right down to the ground.
or he has that look of why me?
Yeah. I can't believe he just called that. That's how the game is played as Council gets it. And so Rochester back out by 9.
Yeah, the other thing, Chris is playing a lot of guys and, you know, trying to get a lot of people minutes here in the first half, which also can lead to a little inconsistency with your offense and stuff.
A foul, and the shot does not go. But Biggs ahead to the line.
Foul, breaking number 6, Gino Green.
Good take there, attacking the basket, drawing a foul.
You see here on the replay.
Devereaux Biggs.
Biggs, excuse me. as he has that go off the rim. His free throw no good.
Chautauqua tried to switch the defense there, and the guy was just late getting there and ended up being out of position, and Biggs took advantage of it.
I tell you, the Hurricanes have caught the Razor Sharks on a bit of a lull here, and the crowd is not into it yet. It's a perfect opportunity to start attacking, try to get back into this lead. This is how the Razor Sharks usually do, team. 6 points turns into 7 and 8, now 10, 39-29. Jumper, that's no good. Biggs with the rebound, he's got it. Nice pass, can Woodson finish? No. And they're gonna call a foul.
Nice pass by Biggs, nice bounce pass. The big man getting out, filling the lane, rewarding him. Like to see that.
Devereaux Biggs here, that's a nice pass. And he got it to the big man, but the Hurricane said this is gonna be easy.
Make him earn it.
So he'll have to go to the line and do that. 8:13 left to go here in the first half. Halftime interview will be Dr. Sev Horvniak of the Premier Basketball League. Razor Sharks. First free throw by Woodson, no good, as that rims around and doesn't fall down.
See if maybe they bring a little full court pressure here after we get a make off the free throw. Try to change the tempo of the game a little bit.
Second one is good. And the Hurricane bringing up the court. Figs. Oh, Figgins, excuse me. Now Ubilis off the dribble. Figs on him. Figs comes out to get him. Nearly stole it away as he gambled, but it goes out of bounds. And it looks like it's going to be Razor Sharks basketball. So Biggs does his job. He frustrated.
Caught a break there.
Yeah. And Yabrilis is the last to touch the ball, so it looks like Rochester will get possession of it. 11-point lead. Ivy, Council, down low Woodson, working against Green. Can't get it over the rim. Woodson gets it back. Put back is good. So the easy money misses, the tough one he gets.
Yes. It worked, stayed with it.
Green step back jumper, no good. Rebounded by Holmes. Sydney Holmes up the court. Biggs drives to the hole. Has it blocked, given back. Woodson thought about a jumper. Spins. I don't know where he was going.
A little out of control there.
Villas pass, extra one, glass, no good. Rebound, put back.
Done a good job of keeping him off the boards to stretch his lead out a little bit, but didn't get it right there.
Ivy with a reverse layup. And that doesn't make Coach happy at all. Romas not liking that. 7 minutes left to go here in this first half. We'll be back with more first half action coming up next here on the Rochester Razor Sharks Broadcast Network. There it is. All right, now I'm ready. I'm sorry. You all right? You all right?
That's funny.
Thank you, John. Back here live at the Blue Cross Arena, 6:52 left to go here in the first half as the Rochester Razor Sharks with the lead here, 44-31. Hurricane have not been able to get that offense consistent in this game, and Biggs is doing a great job defensively, and he's fouled.
Biggs has come in and really given them a lift on the defensive end. He's got his hands on a lot of balls. He's creating havoc.
Oh, man. It's fun to see these new players now adjust because, I mean, you come into this roster, you got a lot of veteran play here. I mean, Corey Ullman's won a few championships. Sharice Crouch has won a few championships. Melvin Counts has won a few championships. James Helton's won a few championships. You know, you've got McGill. You've got young guys. You've got, you know, veteran players. And you're right. He's going deeper into the roster than I would have expected. And now Rashad McGill coming into the game as well. So it looks like he's gotten just about everybody on the roster tonight.
Yeah, it looks like that.
Yabilis thought about a three and pulled it back in. Biggs has been harassing him this entire game he's played him. Now Yabilis working on him. Can't get the shot to go. His rebound is good. And put back. And I'm not sure what call that was.
Delayed game.
Oh, okay.
Yabilis grabbed the ball after scoring.
Oh, they won't. Never understood that. It kind of frustrates me. Stroman is going to have to wait a little bit longer before he gets in. 6:10 left to go here, first half. 13-point lead for Rochester. Ivy, step back jumper. Looked good as soon as it left his hands.
Got a bigger guy on you. Create a little space with the step back. Nice move by John.
Yabilis with it, swinging it around. Hurricane, a little slow developing that offense. Fegan, put back is no good. He's yelling him a foul. Ivy cross court, thought about it. Biggs now counsel, has Fegan on him. He drives towards the hole, scoop layup is good, and one. So this is what happens when you don't have that offense running. Razor Sharks run all over you.
Good transition again. Thought he could have given it to him a little bit sooner in the corner, but Melvin got it and made a nice move to the basket.
Melvin's stride is like two steps. If you're behind him, you get it. You're just not going to be able to not only block the shot, not even contest it. As Holmes gets the offensive rebound, McGill thought about it. Swinging around Ivy. Ivy, corner, council, three, good.
Working on that in practice yesterday. A little penetration and kick to the corner.
Just like that, a 20-point lead for the Rochester Razor Sharks with 5 minutes left to go here in the first half. So the Hurricane have put themselves in a hole. It's going to take a lot to dig them out of it. Yabilis with it. Biggs on him. Frustrating. Three. That's no good. Back of the iron. Council with the rebound. Up the court they go. Council. Extra pass, Holmes, reverse layup is good. Excuse me, McGill, reverse layup is good. And
something on the court here. Chautauqua not getting the advantages that they were earlier in the game with the, you know, running their offense and getting some of the mismatches with the bigs. Biggs himself has come in and created havoc.
True.
It's kind of changed how Chautauqua's been able to do things. Early on, they were able to get at the basket because they were getting some of those mismatches. And Coach Iverson, obviously, they made an adjustment, and they haven't been able to get those.
Well, in this particular situation, now what do? Your offense hasn't worked. You haven't been able to, you know, keep the ball away from the defensive crew that's in right now from the Razor Sharks. And, you know, you can barely get anything at the rim. A lot of the stuff that the Hurricane have gotten have been on second shot opportunities and scrappiness.
Right.
So that's a scrappy 33 points up there.
Right. And when you're not getting good shots and getting stuff at the basket, you're not getting those second chance opportunities now. And, you know, now we're seeing why the lead's up to 22.
So with 4:23 left to go here in this first half, the Rochester Razor Sharks, John Ivy.
Having a good debut. Hit some jump shots, got some assists, got into the basket.
And it's interesting, well, you know, what happens when your second unit is performing better than your first unit. No starters. Dele Coker now back in the game. He was a starter, but he's just coming back in. But no starters on the court right now for Rochester.
I think it also alludes to the depth that the Razor Sharks have, that, you know, they could probably start just about any combination of five.
Hodge with it right now. Ivy draws him defensively. He had it knocked away, and Ivy goes back to him. Stroman with it. 12 on the shot clock. He's going to find a way to get the ball. How about a little closer? Hodge is no good off the hands of Coker out of bounds. But so hard for them to just get it.
What you've seen is as guys have come in off the bench, the defensive intensity has really picked up, and I think that's also really disrupted Chautauqua, is just the energy that the bench guys have brought. I mean, McGill's getting up after people, Biggs has been getting after people, you know, Ivy's been getting after people.
That's off the hands of Hodge, unless they see it another way, and they do. So Chautauqua keeps it. Hodge trying to inbounds, finds Stroman. Has he stepped out of bounds? Yeah, they said that he did.
Out of bounds, Rochester Bulldogs.
So the Razor Sharks getting ready to add to their lead, 3:40. It's been a terrible second quarter for the Hurricane.
And again, a lot of it has to do with the bench production that they've gotten from guys like Biggs and Ivy.
No good. Higgins with the rebound, trying to pass it to, I think, two people at the same time. Thank goodness one of them caught it. Three is no good. I mean, can you pull yourself back into this getting threes, or do you need a number of good twos? Put Holmes, reverse layup, can't get it. Coker put back, can't get it. Knocked away. Hodge comes away with it. Driving straight towards the hole. They're going to call charge. Yep.
That's a foul.
Yep. They say he was out of control. 3:06 left to go.
He definitely was out of control.
Well, how do you
go in against the bigs? He's, you know, where are you going here against this?
Yeah, McGill had his hands up, perfect position, out of the restriction zone. As John Ivy gets a nice round of applause for coming out. And so Helton will come in for him. Just under 3 minutes left to go here, first half. Stolen away, Hodge. Can he get there before Coker? No, he can't. Coker saves it. Out of bounds. It will be Rochester basketball.
Great hustle by Coker, not giving up on the play. Pursuing,
wow,
blocking the shot.
Very impressive by Dele Coker. I didn't think he was going to catch him.
Longer strides.
I don't underestimate Dele Coker. That's what I just learned. I thought Hodge had a head of steam and was going to score there. 2:48 as you see it on the replay. Rochester up 57-33. The rest of the first half coming up next here on the Rochester Razor Sharks Broadcast Network.
The Blue Cross Arena at 57-33. Rochester with the lead here. As we've got 2:48 left to go here in the first half. And the Razor Sharks have put the pedal to the metal offensively. Chautauqua just can't find their offensive rhythm. And that's what happens in one particular quarter. It's that fast.
And again, it's not the starters. It's the guys that came in off the bench, giving a lot of energy on the defensive end, shutting down Chautauqua, and then taking advantage of those opportunities on the other end.
And we're about to slide right into it.
They just wanted to say hi, John. Both the Hodge and Biggs are going after the ball. Coker, Biggs, scoop layup, and they're going to say offensive.
Yep. Came a little bit too much of the shoulder.
To give you an example of how bad that second quarter has gone thus far with 2:39 left to go here in the first half. Chautauqua's only scored 9 points. Not going to work.
No.
Especially with Rochester scoring 30. Knocked away. Picked up Helton 2-on-1. This doesn't even seem fair. And Helton able to cash it in.
But again, keeping guys off the board, getting out in transition, really been the key this second quarter.
A Hurricane finding themselves deeper down in the hole. Billis, pull up, push off. Are they going to call a foul? Oh, no, it goes the other way. Okay. Donald was going to be a push off there.
Yeah.
Well, that's all right.
Gave him a little bit of a chicken wing there, but they didn't call it.
Hodge the inbounds. Ivy on him. Gets it out to Stroman. One-on-one against Helton. Helton blocks it. Stroman rebound. 6 seconds on the shot clock. Block again. Knocked out of bounds. It will be Razor Sharks basketball.
Off of Stroman. And again, not getting the matchups on the isolations that they were getting in the first quarter. They're not getting the mismatches, you know, with a lot of, like, you know, with Ubilis on some of the bigs and being able to take advantage of it.
Chichester down low, reverse layup, McGill. Oh. That's the matchup you want, too, when you get that matchup.
Yeah.
You want to capitalize on it.
And Rochester took advantage of that mismatch.
Top of the key, swinging around Ubilis.
Been quiet this quarter.
Billis scoop layup is good.
Evan Ubaugh for two for Chautauqua. Shot ball.
So with a minute left to go, the Razor Sharks just keep answering buckets against the Hurricanes. Three. Biggins can't get it to go. Coker, rebound. So Rochester not picking up their play.
Yeah, not good offense there. One pass, jump shot. There's no one moving. It's hard to get an offensive rebound when there's no movement. And one pass and a jump shot just doesn't work.
So with 45 seconds left to go, we'll have Dr. Sev and Chichester can't get it in. He believes he was sort of shoved there by the body. No call, but not going to get those. Stroman, three. That's no good. Chichester rebound over the back.
Good contest again by Coker. And a good box out by Chichester.
And Fegans, who's got, you know, Chichester's got a few inches on him. Just going for the ball. And sometimes when that happens, you land on someone. Especially when you got to go up against a big. No hard feelings.
The little guy always loses in those battles.
Not much you can really do about it.
Nah.
You just make a play for the ball. If he gets it before you do, you try to wrestle it away. If he can't, you can go back on defense. So Chichester at the line with 33 seconds left to go here in the first half.
What those bigs don't understand is as a little guy, you got to reach up. You're going to hit something.
That's right.
And as a little guy, we always get hit with the elbow. So, yeah. You know, because we're down at that level.
Oh, it is nothing worse than an inadvertent elbow. Chichester's second one. As he makes both. 30 seconds, about a 9-second difference between the shot clock and game clock. Trying to finish, scoop layup, no good. Knocked away, McGill, as all the bodies hit the floor. McGill, helped by Hodge, knocked away. That almost gets out of bounds, it does. And guys are flying all over the place to try to get to that ball.
Hodge is, he's tough on the ball handler. He's so small and so quick. Really got to take care of the basketball when he's guarding you.
Shot clock turned off with 5 seconds left to go, and a foul. They're going to get Coker for it.
They had one to give there? No. Yeah, they had one to give there.
Well, Dele took a chance at it.
Okay, no, it wasn't.
So that means, is that, yep, they're in the bonus. So yeah. That means that Ubilis will go to the line.
I thought they were taking one there because they had one to give, but. And I think Coach Iverson did, too. He's not real happy about that.
He's double-checking now just to make sure that there was, if there was or if there wasn't. Really, the good foul on this is, if you had one to give, it's not a bad foul.
Right.
If you didn't have one to give, it's not a good foul.
No, clearly,
now it's not a good foul.
Right. You put their best player at the free throw line.
Yeah.
But I think Coach Iverson definitely thought that they had one to give there. I don't think he was – you want to foul their best player with 2 seconds left.
That's always an easy one for a coach. You can be very happy or not be happy, depending on whether or not you're over the limit or not.
Well, somebody on the bench is getting yelled at right now because they gave him some bad information.
Yeah, exactly, yeah. Somebody's not keeping the book right. Ivy.
Oh!
That looked good when it left but didn't go down. Rochester Razor Sharks 65-37 over the Chautauqua Hurricanes. We'll be back with first half stats talk with Dr. Sev and company coming up next at halftime here on the Rochester Razor Sharks Broadcast Network.
Back here live at the Blue Cross Arena, halftime for the Rochester Razor Sharks, 65-37 over Chautauqua and the Hurricane. We're joined now by the collective group here in charge of the Rochester Razor Sharks Premier Basketball League. Dr. Sev, as always, good to see you, my friend. How are you?
Thanks for having me back again. Another exciting year to kick off the New Year's Eve. Welcome.
Well, you've got a team here in the Razor Sharks that have won the championship 3 years in a row. Looking for a fourth one. What does it feel like to have that banner up there yet again?
Well, a really exciting feeling, not just for the guys on the team, but for the community. Everybody's happy. That was a great one-point win at the end of the season last year, and we're glad we did a three-peat. Let's go for a four-peat. Looks like the guys are ready to play.
Well, I tell you, you got a nice crowd on hand. The New Year's Eve game is back. It's always great to see a great crowd.
It's great to have a big crowd on New Year's Eve, and I'm very happy and excited, and hopefully they'll be coming for more games.
Yep. Paul Rosen joins us now, of course, on our show. Now, this is going to be another big year for the Razor Sharks again. Last year was fun. I know you got a chance to be exposed to some of it for the brand new year. This year, what was it like for you to stand on that court and see what you've seen before, a championship, but know you were a part of it from last year into this year?
Well, what's really, really last year was awesome, and it was a lot of fun. What's really exciting about this year is, in addition to having eight of our players back and having a lot of our core players between Corey and Deli and Melvin and some of the other players, we got really, really big. So in addition to Josh and Deli, we added Dominic Woodson, who's a 6'11", 290-pound kid with quick feet.
Yeah.
This kid was an ESPN top recruit, went to Huntington Prep, which is where Andrew Wiggins and Thomas Bryant went, and he's really good. We also have Jordan Rayleigh, a 7-footer who played for the 76ers organization in the D League. So yeah, we got really big. We also picked up John Ivey, local second five kid, who played at Brockport.
A lot of fans for John tonight.
Yeah, absolutely. So what's really, really cool and fun about this year is, in addition to kind of the core group from last year, got a lot of fun new players. The other thing we're looking at doing, Tariq, is we're looking at signing Bob Wagner, the 7'8" gentleman.
Big Bob?
Big Bob.
Oh,
so we're looking at bringing
wow.
him back. This will be more of a developmental year for him.
Okay.
He recently had foot surgery, so we're looking to bring him in, spend some time with fans and schools and sponsors.
Yeah.
He'll work out with the team, and hopefully by mid to end of the year, we can put him in a little bit.
Well, you know, it's interesting. You're always expanding. Dr. Sev has been here, of course, since the Jump Street, but you've also expanded in the office as well. I wanted to get to know Lawrence for a minute. Hi, Lawrence. How's it going?
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too. Welcome in. So now you're sort of the fresh face, brand new to the organization. What have you seen thus far? I know you've been around for a minute. We haven't been able to talk. I know you had a very hectic schedule. But what's it been like to being a part of this franchise that is really the elite in the Premier Basketball League?
Well, I landed luckily. Thanks, Doc Sev answered the door. So here I am. But what we're trying to do in the community coming up is get more kids involved. This is a program for the Rochester community and for the children.
Yeah.
So what we're trying to do is reach out deeper into the community and just bring everybody into the door so we can get a bigger house.
Well, I see now you got the youth kid playing here as well. You've even drafted my son as a ball boy, which is fine.
Yes.
He needs a job.
Yes, he needs a great job.
You don't need him a paycheck yet, though. That's okay. But you've seen that before. You guys go to clinics. You guys do clinics. You invite, you know, players to come to talk to kids, go to schools. It's been a part of the Razor Sharks community for a while, just adding more to that.
Yes. We're adding a different layer. We like the older community to get a little bit more involved.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to work on our media relationships to try to get more media in the door, as we are a number one basketball premier team around here. There's another
absolutely.
One. So.
Yeah.
We need a little support from the community, and we're going to just meet them at the table.
Sounds good. Thank you. Of course, I got to say, personally, it was an opportunity that your brother gave me to do this job. And, I know it's a tough loss for you. Our condolences go out for Horace.
Thank you.
But he put me in this seat, gave me this opportunity, and I'll be forever grateful.
Yeah, we miss him. We're going to have a special night, tribute night, memorial night for him, probably in the first or second week of February. And we're trying to invite all his friends in the media and all around Western New York that he touched, and hopefully have a big crowd and celebrate his life.
Definitely a great man. Thank you for the time, guys. Appreciate it. Second half coming up next. Let's see if Chautauqua can get back into this one.
Right.
Here the Rochester Razor Sharks Broadcast Network.
Thanks, Tariq.
Yep.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hey, John.
Whew. Back here live at the Blue Cross Arena, Razor Sharks, as you can see, putting that banner up for 2016 right there in the middle, trying to do so in 2017 with their first game of the year. Tariq Spence, John Boone with you here today as we start off a second half. All right, not that you've ever coached a team this far down before, John, but what is the first thing you're saying to a team that's trying to come back into this one down by 32?
Well, you just got to try to go out and keep playing hard and keep working on things. It's early in the season, and try to see what we do well, what we don't do well, to keep trying to use as the season progresses is really all you can try to do. And, you know, if you start making a little run at them, that's even better.
For the Rochester Razor Sharks, first half statistics telling the whole story, not just the 65 points for Rochester in that first half as Corey Allman dishes the Helton three in the corner is good. But rebounding pretty even, turnovers pretty even. Rochester just shooting that much better. Not so much, but that much better from the field. And Chautauqua, I mean, they've had their opportunities to get the offense rolling, but they've scrapped for every point they've got.
Well, great pass by Jarice there. Well, the second quarter, they really just, they went cold. They were 5 for 23 in the second quarter, while the Razor Sharks were 13 of 24 in the second quarter. And that was really where they started to pull away.
John Ivey leading the way for Rochester. He had 12 points in that first half. And Yabilis with 10 to lead the way for the Hurricane. Corey Allman can't get that shot to fall just yet. Putback is good.
But again, a lot of good minutes out of the bench. You know, Ivy gave him 12 good minutes. Council gave him 12 good minutes.
Jarice Crouch right towards the middle of the court. Dele Coker is fouled by Green. So Gino Green fouling Coker. Coker will go to the line to shoot two.
Now, the one thing you don't want to see is what you're starting to see with Chautauqua is not a lot of energy to start this third quarter. This could get real ugly fast if they don't pick up the energy level a little bit.
You know, it is a, you know, obviously a four-quarter game. In that second quarter, you rewind a bit, and people may not have realized, if you haven't been watching us, just tuned in, we had a 27-24 lead for Rochester. And one quarter where it doesn't work. You don't get your offense going. You can't get your defense going. It could fall apart and put you in a hole that deep. And that's exactly what just happened.
And again,
so now what?
It started at the defensive end. They really turned up the defensive pressure. And Chautauqua didn't have an answer for it.
Yabilis trying to get the ball down low. Green tried to save it. Can't do it. Goes out of bounds.
They'd always jump in the air and have to make a decision. Eventually gravity takes over.
For the Razor Sharks now, you dig deeper into your bench, let a lot of guys start to play here if you are able to hold on to this lead.
Well, the starters didn't really play a whole lot in the first half, so you might see them actually go a little bit farther in this game.
Works it down low. Coker wanted to jam it. Green said no, and so he fouled him.
He does go hard to the basket. Even watch him in practice the other day. He tries to dunk everything.
Well, Dele is a very intense competitor, as all the Razor Sharks are. But he does not let that intensity just end here during the games. At practice, he goes hard, very focused, very serious, doesn't joke around a lot. Not a bit of a prankster. I mean, he laughs with his teammates and has fun with them. But when it's time to practice, it's time to stretch, he takes everything very seriously. As a professional should.
Yeah, yeah.
Knocked away. Picked up. Coker gives it to Crouch.
And again, Yabilis just trying to do too much instead of running their offense and trying to get good shots.
And foul call on Allman. Say he was trying to put it up, so he'll go to the free throw line. It could be a lot worse. Corey Allman could have that offense moving, and then we'd be looking at a 50-point lead.
Yeah, Corey's a little cold in the first half. It's 2 for 6 from the three.
That first free throw, no good. So Corey had a tough time getting it open offensively. Rest of the team picking it up. Second free throw is good by Ullman. Takwa.
Good hedge by Coker there.
The defense by the Razor Sharks is up on Chautauqua. Big three is no good. Rebound picked up.
And again, something that Chautauqua was doing early was getting offensive rebounds, and that hasn't happened. They only had 5 in the second quarter after having 13 in the first quarter.
Swinging it around. Big three there. That's no good. Rebound tipped around, and back the other way go the Hurricanes. So 74-39. Rochester with the lead. Another three. No good. So they're just chucking it here. As Barry took another three.
Bounce pass gets through.
Fegan will go right up. Blocked by Coker. Knocked down goes Crouch. Barry gets Crouch up. And we're going to try to find out who knocked that out of bounds last.
It's Chautauqua ball. Coach Moss for Chautauqua looking for anything right now as he talks to the officials.
Yeah, sort of a come on, give me one here. Crossing over, swinging it around. Yabilis ends up with it, driving towards the hole, trying to go around the defense, pull back jumper, no good. Fegan is going to be called, loose ball foul, stay there. So what I thought was going to be on Fegan might be on Crouch.
Rochester's foul number 4, Jerice Crouch. Jerice first.
Jerice kind of get caught out of position there on the shot and just had to foul him on the rebound.
Inbounds, swings it over. Yabilis seems to be going one-on-one a lot. Nobody moving.
Well, and one of the adjustments is they're not really trying not to switch that screen like they were earlier in the game.
Jumper no good. Knocked around. Green had it out of bounds. It'll remain Hurricane basketball to the surprise of some Razor Sharks.
I think Jordan Raley's one of them.
Yeah. Can't argue those calls. Just got to go with it.
Especially when you're up 35.
Yeah. Jumper. Good. Outside jumper there. So Gatewood with a big jumper. Erie. Ullman, 3. Straight up, straight down. So hot and cold Corey Ullman tonight so far. Had a couple drop. He's had a couple clank. But Rochester up 77-41. Yabilis, scoop layup is good and a foul.
And again, they didn't play it like they have been. They ended up railing up, switching on them, and Yabilis was able to take advantage.
77-43. Jordan Raley, his 3rd. The score with Yabilis up. With 7:19 left to go.
Jelani shooting 1
in
for the Hurricane number
50, third quarter.
Edwin Hubau.
First free throw is good by Yabilis, or excuse me, and
3 point
one
play for Hubau. Shark ball.
3 point play there. Cuts it down to a 33 point deficit. Ullman had it come off his hand, gets it back. Crouch, down low, Coker. Coker, turnaround, knocked away, picked up, Yabilis trips but still keeps his footing. Gatewood had it, 3, takes it, no good, rebounded
Jerice Crouch,
by
Crouch. Picks up a loose ball.
Back the other way, McGill, not enough on defense.
Get down, Rashad McGill.
And again, Jerice with his head up, McGill breaking out on the shot and wide open layup.
swinging it around, Fegan. That three has not looked good.
Reese with another rebound.
Every single
ball.
Time that Gatewood's taken it.
Another one by Allman.
Three ball, Corey Allman.
Excuse me, by Barry. Barry's three does not look good. And an 82-44 lead, 6:20 left to go here in the third quarter. Full timeout. And so the Razor Sharks right now just rolling.
Well,
so
if you're Coach Iverson, what you want to try to do is, you know, try to run your offense.
Need a timeout.
It's early in the season. It was one of the things you were talking about in practice yesterday. You
Presto Cleaners, the official cleaners of your Rochester Razor Sharks.
This is a good time to try to work on that. You're up 38.
Have them pick up your laundry.
You know, keep the starters in a little while. Keep working on those kinds of things. And you know, obviously the bench is has been very productive too. And you're going to want them to do the same things. I mean, I would never tell guys to stop playing. I mean, if you get wide open layups like McGill had, you definitely take it. But there's opportunities here to work on things that they're going to help you as the season goes on. And, you know, a game like this is when you want to try to take advantage of that. You know, on the Chautauqua side, you got to try to find guys that want to keep playing.
We'll find out if they still want to play here in the third quarter coming up next on the Rochester Razor Sharks Broadcast Network. Back here live at the Blue Cross Arena, 6:20 left to go here in the third quarter. 82-44, Rochester with the commanding lead. Seen it shake down a little bit better in previous years where leads like this disappear, but Rochester really looks locked in here, and Erie just doesn't have anybody to continuously score.
It's amazing. They scored 24 points in the first quarter. They scored 18 points. Since, yeah. 20 points since.
Yeah. It's just that and I wasn't really sure exactly how, looking back on that first quarter, they were able to do it. But I mean, it was just hustle. I think the first unit really couldn't get anything going. And remember, that was an ugly shooting first quarter too.
Yeah, and the other team was shooting more than 30%.
So Dele Coker in to the free throw line again. 5:50 left to go here in the third quarter.
What we don't want is a free throw shooting contest
because
we all have New Year's Eve plans, I think. So.
Well, yeah, and it's still some time before they fire off some fireworks. So, you know, it's great to wait in the parking lot when the fireworks are coming in 30 minutes as opposed to an hour. You know. There'll be plenty of time to get wherever you need to go for the ball to drop if we hurry it along here. In the corner, Stroman. Coker comes out to defend him. He's swinging it around. Green now with it, top of the key. Stroman strides in, can't get it to go.
Good defense by Raley.
So Raley has it go off of his hand, the back of his hands, and out of bounds.
I got to be aware there's only 2 seconds on the shot clock. Catch and shoot kind of situation.
Knocked away. McGill to Allman, and they were trying to finish on a fast break.
They're calling a shot clock violation, saying the violation happened before he got possession of the ball. So it should be the Razor Sharks ball here at half court.
Worked out. Coach Iverson said didn't like it. Works out for you.
He still got his 2 points.
Yeah. Yep. For the start of the season, for the Razor Sharks, you couldn't ask for anything more. For the Hurricane, a lot to work on when you're taking on the best. And it's always tough, though, when you're taking on a team you know has a history and a tradition of being ready to play. It's not like you're, you know, taking on a team that, you know, has never played before. This is a team that's played before, knows what to do. They've been through this so many different times. And for Chautauqua, I mean, they still need to put some pieces together, get some offense, and find ways to
I think you're also play seeing, hard. I think you're also seeing how 8 returning players on a roster and a relatively new roster early on, too. These guys have probably, you know, only been practicing really together for, you know, a couple of weeks.
They're not going to call. Oh, I thought they were going to call a late violation. And so they say it's a late violation.
Yep,
no basket.
They did call a violation.
Oh, so no basket. So a 40-point lead. I was kidding about the 50, but we're actually creeping up on it.
Yeah.
5:02 left to go here in the third. And no reason. And so they're going to say a push-off on Council. And Hodge gets rewarded for good defense.
Hodge has been pesky on ball handlers this game.
Hodge 3. That's no good, front rim. Raley with the rebound. McGill with it. Cross court. Swings it around. Allman, they stay close on him. Backdoor pass. McGill, reverse layup.
Nice cut, nice pass. Great vision there by Allman.
Hodge, Council all over him. Cross court. Swings it around. Stroman. That's a 2. That's no good. Rebounded by McGill. Off to the races again. Passes. Council for 3. That's no good. Rebound. Knocked out of bounds, and it will be Rochester basketball.
And all those offensive rebounds Chautauqua was getting in the first quarter, not happening here in the third quarter. Just not as active as they were in that first 12 minutes.
So the Razor Sharks now will inbounds. As Council comes out to get it. Hodge, as you said, on him. Allman, don't let him get comfortable back there. Down low, Woodson. Woodson. And foul. Railing headed to the free throw line. Looked like he was going to slam it. Get the crowd on their feet here, but on that wrist.
Nice find by Hodgson. Catching the post. Nice backdoor cut by Raley. And yeah, he was going to dunk it if he didn't get fouled.
On the arm.
Chino Green got enough of him.
So first one's good. McGill will come out. Biggs is in.
Biggs was a catalyst in that second quarter. Came in, and him and Ivy really got this team going.
Defense strong. Up behind the back. Player wasn't looking. Got it back. Don't see that a lot. Jumper is good by Green. So Gino Green puts it up. Hodge all over Biggs. Allman for 3. That's no good. Rebound off the tips of Woodson's hands. Down the court, Green thought about it. Drives off glass, can't get it to go. Woodson with the rebound. Back the other way come the Razor Sharks. Biggs with it, 3:15 left to go, third quarter.
Nice move.
Tries to get it to Woodson out of bounds, off of his leg. Oh, Hodge bring it across midcourt.
Go middle, Corey.
Strowman throws baseline. Layup gets it to fall.
What you don't want to see him doing is stop playing defense.
Yeah.
I don't care what the score is. You want him to still keep playing hard, contesting shots, and guarding people. I mean, those are the habits you want to try to instill early in the season.
Now, you've been coaching or coached for how long? How many years in the game?
I've been in I was involved with it for 23 years at the college and high school level.
And at that sort of level, I want to talk a little bit about that. 89-49. As the Rochester RazorSharks have the lead, 2:39 left to go here in the third quarter. We'll be back with the rest of the third coming up in a matter of moments. Thank you for watching on this New Year's Eve night, the Rochester RazorSharks Broadcast Network. Rochester with the lead, 40 points as the first game of the brand new year. Looks good for Rochester. 2:39 left to go here in the third quarter. Tariq Spence, John Boone with you here as we get ready to wrap up this third quarter, heading into the fourth. Hopefully you're enjoying your New Year's Eve night and get ready to go have some nice, wholesome fun. First free throw by Woodson is good. So, Coach, I was asking a bit about, you know, in the years of competing and not letting letting up, going hard. You've coached for years at a couple of different levels. Your sort of thoughts on that in the sense that if there's time on the clock, you go hard no matter what?
Yeah, I mean, it just makes it a habit. You want to play hard all the time and, you know, and make it a habit of playing hard all the time.
The same goes in practice?
Yes. That's where it starts is in practice, too.
So never a dull moment. You don't want any dull moments in practice, and you don't want any lost moments in the game.
Well, no, I think, the habits you develop in practice are what you bring into a game. And, that's really what you bring to the game is what you work hard in practice. If you don't work hard in practice, it's hard. You can't turn it on and off.
Is there this understanding of, and I've asked this before many coaches, you're not the first, of making sure that guys are challenging or ladies are challenging each other and it doesn't get personal. It doesn't get to the point where it goes over the line that I'm trying to get you better so I can be better and we can be better, sort of that sort of philosophy.
Well, I think as a coach, that's what you try to create in practice, every day, or competitions. Everything's done with a consequence, whether it be a sprint or a push-up or whatever. One guy gets an earlier water break than another, whatever it is.
Yeah.
I think the more competition that you create with everything that you do, makes your team, better and stronger.
Well, it's the toughest part about that too is that, especially when you have a team Reverse layup no good by McGill. He wanted a foul. Wasn't going to get it. Minute 13 left to go. Floater no good. Rebound. Back the other way, Rochester. McGill, Council left alone. Stride, scoop layup in for two.
And again, just Chautauqua, just the effort's just not there like it was in the first quarter. I mean, four guys barely made it across half court before Melvin laid it in.
And the other, I got to ask, in a sense that, you know, if you've got kids who play or at a young level, when does it sort of switch over from we're playing this as fun and instructional to we're playing and this is fun and I want to make sure that we're getting better each time we play? That's that fine line,
right? Right.
Of knowing it.
And I think a lot of it, I think once you get to the varsity level, up to the high school level is when, you know, the wins and losses really start to matter. I think we do too much of it sometimes with the younger ages when they really need more to learn about skill than about winning and losing.
And the development of the game, which is very tough.
Right.
As Dominic Woodson puts that jam down. And with 13 seconds left to go here in the third quarter, the Razor Sharks putting the pedal to the metal.
Another illegal defense on Woodson.
As Hodge puts it in. And the reason I ask, because you have so many people who have different philosophies on the game and how it should be played and, you know, how, you know, when to take the pedal off, when to not take the pedal off. And if a competitive sport, you're talking about a professional level, it's hard all the way.
Right, right. And like I said, I don't think, you know, like Woodson had the dunk there, I don't think you do things where you don't try to score.
Yeah.
You know, but there's an amount of professionalism is where you don't try to show people up either. Mm-hmm. But I think sometimes not trying to score is almost showing up as bad as it is, you know.
Trying to score.
Yeah. You know, so.
Stroman with the free throw line. But it is that fine line in between how good a team is and are they ready to play. Because once you go in those lines, it is what it is.
Right. And these guys are pros. They're getting paid to play. So it's a little bit different than, you know, a high school or even a college team sometimes. Because these guys, it's their livelihood.
Yeah.
And you know, that 12th man is trying to, you know, keep earning a paycheck, so he needs to keep playing hard just as much as, you know, the best player on the team does.
That's no good. We'll talk a little bit more about that as the Rochester Razor Sharks cruising here in the third quarter, 98-55 over Chautauqua and the Hurricane. One more quarter to go before we put this one in the books. Thank you for watching the Rochester Razor Sharks Broadcast Network. Thank you. YouTube and in their website. They usually do that. Back here live at the Blue Cross Arena, 98-56. Rochester with the lead. Fourth quarter about to start. And Rochester put a banner up in the Blue Cross Arena, and if the score holds the way it is, looks like they'll put another one up there. If they continue to play the way they're playing this way the rest of the year. Now, the other thing, Coach, you know, you got a team that's going to get a win today here at the Razor Sharks. It doesn't mean you win another championship because you played your first game and you won.
Right.
You still have to do this for the next 3 months.
Right.
And keeping a team focused.
Yeah, and they're gonna be tested, and you know that's what you're looking for. It's how they respond the first time they're tested.
Well, there will be a lot of teams that will face Rochester throughout the season, as I said before. Matchups that will be interesting will always be Jamestown, Rochester. Looking forward to Kentucky again. Mavericks are a very good organization, and. So they're going to be teams down the line that will not let a 40 clip or a 50 clip get placed on them. For the Hurricane, it was just a tough one tonight. They couldn't get any shots going. They couldn't get any offensive going. No one stayed consistent.
Yeah, especially after that first quarter.
Yep, and the numbers will catch you. Yeah. Chichester can't make his free throw. So still 98-56. Stroman. Hodge. Swinging it around. They're running a good system. Hurricane just can't get the shot they want. Yeah. I tell you, that defensive rotation, talk a little bit about that. Guys moving around the ball. No one was left open very long.
No, and they did a good job of, at the end of the shot clock, getting that trap and forcing the pass. And Chautauqua not really paying attention to how much time was on the clock. Usually that's a bench thing. Guys should be yelling from the bench when the shot clock's winding down, so guys are aware of it.
Chautauqua, that was near their side of the court, too. You don't want anybody checking out either. You want to continue to get in. For these players, it's an opportunity to showcase their ability to the next level.
Right.
A lot of these guys are young. Some are looking for maybe a shot at the D-League. Some are looking for a shot maybe bigger than the D-League. Some, when this season's over, may go to another league overseas or, an opportunity to continue playing basketball.
Right. And that's why you want to play, hard throughout. Because you never know who's in here watching. Because all these guys are looking for opportunities to keep playing. And it's a great life if you can do it, playing basketball.
Well, I didn't realize until I got into the Razor Sharks organization how many different leagues there are, guys trying to get to these different leagues, play,
And then overseas, there's tons of opportunities over there, too, that keep opening up.
Where people love this sport. The sport is... I didn't realize how much, how many different leagues there are and opportunities for these young guys to, somebody will take care of their room and board and pay them for this ability to play. McGill luckily got the spin to go down on that alley-oop from Biggs.
The previous possession, Woodson catches the ball that deep. There's not too many people at any level that can guard him down there with that body.
104 to 58. Hodge, three. No good. Front rim. Or is that an air ball? Carol's letting me know that's an air ball. Tired legs, 9:30 left to go. Not the way you want to start your New Year's Eve night. And Hodge is foul on Biggs.
Bill is coming back in.
So Council will inbounds. Stroman on him defensively. Biggs with it. McGill off glass, no good. He didn't like that shot. His face, his grimace on his face is that he didn't like that shot. That wasn't even approved by the guy who shot it.
He's checking his wrist.
Yeah.
When it goes in, they don't look at anything.
No.
When they miss, there's always something going on.
Big jumper is no good, in and out, rebounded by Stroman. Up the court he goes. 9:15 left to go here in the game. Rochester up 104-58.
I'd say Coach Iverson could start emptying his bench, but he's played everybody throughout, so really not a lot to do there.
Yeah, we're just running minutes off the clock. Woodson, thank you for making everybody sort of get up and see that dunk in real time. I think Dominic Woodson starting to say, hey, you know, kind of getting a little tired here.
They're saying once if he can get into a little bit better shape,
yeah,
he's going to be – it's one of the things – yeah.
Yeah, that was a I need to get out of the game, coach. That was an I need to get out of the game, coach, foul.
I'm tired. That's in there.
I also got to ask if they tell another player, like, hey, nothing personal, but I got to get out of this game. Can you do understand that I'm
yeah, I'm tired.
This is not against you personally. It's just I need to go lay down. No. Stroman, McGill on him, gets him to back up. Head fake, scoop layup, can't get it to go, but a foul. 8:34 left to go here in the fourth. And I believe that's going to be a timeout. So it will. 8:34 left to go here in the game. Rochester will start off their season with a win. We'll play more of the fourth quarter coming up next here on the Rochester Razor Sharks Broadcast Network.
Welcome back here live at the Blue Cross Arena, 106-58. Rochester with the lead here today. 8:34 left to go here in the fourth quarter. And Daquan Stroman is at the free throw line. Yeah. Hey. Stroman's second free throw. No good. And what's the foul on? I don't know what that is. Lane violation?
Another violation.
On Chichester or Holmes? I think Holmes.
Holmes pointing at himself.
Yep.
So.
Yep. Said that was me.
Fagan's gotten a couple of those guys to fall in early.
And Stroman able to capitalize on that. Just need about 46 more of those. That's all. And we got a ball game. And another whistle. Quick. That's going to be on Stroman.
And again, if you're Rochester, you want to just try to run your offense, keep working on the execution, and, you know, work on plays and do things that are going to help you get better as the season goes on.
Inbound, Biggs figging on him. Biggs thought about a three and it's reconsidered. Scoop layup is no good. Boy, that looked good all the way. Just couldn't get it to go down.
Nice move, just couldn't finish.
Strowman has Holmes on him. Defensively, stays with him. Swinging it around. Nine on the shot clock. Somebody's going to put something up. Deegans will do it. And that's no good. Rebounded by McGill. Put back is good.
That's just unlucky ball there.
So Ruttage able to make good on that mistake. Chichester, no one rotated, and that was that. So never seen a guy that open on the in the paint.
These guys went with the ball and someone didn't talk.
7 minutes left to go, a little bit more than that here in the game. Swinging it around. 5 seconds to go on a shot clock. Good shot there.
Good defense, just a tough shot.
Corner, McGill thought about it. He's going to bring it back out. Now down low to Holmes. Holmes working around and in for two. With Sidney Holmes able to cash in. Not Chichester, but that's okay. There we go. Three, that's no good. Front rim, off to the races. Council in for two. So six, a little bit more than 6 minutes left to go. James Helton will be checking in for a matter of moments.
And again, if you're Chautauqua, you know, keep trying to do things to help you get better for the next game. And, you know, keep trying to run an offense and do things.
Step back jumper, off glass and in for two. Villas, Edwin. Biggs for three is good. So Biggs from outside makes that one. Devereaux Biggs playing very well today. 5:30 left to go. Yabilis, and there's a foul away from the ball.
Now illegal defense again.
And with 5:29 left to go here in the first half, we'll take a timeout. And the Rochester Razor Sharks leading at 115-66 here in the fourth. Thank you for watching the Rochester Razor Sharks Broadcast Network. Back here live at the Blue Cross Arena, 115-66. Rochester leading it over the Hurricane of Chautauqua. Tariq Spence and John Boone here with you as we get ready to wrap up this game at 5:29 left to go here in the fourth. Rochester will come away with the win, Erie with a loss. And for the Razor Sharks, still long way to go before you start putting another banner in the Blue Cross Arena. Yabilis makes the free throw after the illegal defense is called. And it's about three more months before the regular season is done. And then you have that march towards the playoffs yet again. And that's when it starts getting interesting yet again.
Well, if you're Coach Iverson, you got to be pleased with, especially the contributions you got from your bench early. You know, when you're starting to see that you got some depth.
Yeah.
And you know, those are the things that you like to see, especially in the first game, obviously, besides the win.
James Helton just made a move and a shot I didn't really think you could make. But that's impressive. Backspin on the basketball, on the layup. Gatewood down low, Stroman. Working against Ivy. That's in and out, no good. Though that's exactly how the balls have been treating the Hurricane. In, out, not going down, not enough to get it over the rim. They've suffered a lot of in-and-out shots.
Yeah, and then didn't get any rebounds either.
Help three, that's no good. Rebound Yabilis with 4.5 left to go here in the game. And Chichester. Foul called there as he was going on that fast break. And front line change for the Hurricane. And they'll send everybody else who hasn't played into the game.
After Yabilis takes a couple free throws here.
Yabilis will come out. And Alex Crossan will come in for him. He's the shooter. Oh, nope, Yabilis is out. So
I guess it called it on the floor.
Yep. Changed it from shooting foul to floor. Barry Hodge. 12 on the shot clock. Got to know that. 8 now. Hurricane hard to get into their offense. Drive towards the hole. Charging foul. Yep, they will. They'll call it charging foul. And McGill is hurt.
His wrist again.
And he's been nursing that right wrist.
Yeah, landed on it there, taking the charge.
So McGill is out, injury sub. So Biggs comes back in. So Ivy, Holmes, Chichester, Biggs, and Helton out on the court for the Razor Sharks. 117-67. Rochester with the lead. Helton, scoop layup, no good. Put back by Holmes is good. Tip drill works.
Good penetration. Again, running a set, getting a good shot.
3:39 left to go here in the game. Scoop layup is good by Barry. So Barry gets it in for two. Ivy trying to get it to Chichester. Barry comes away with the steal. Helton all over him. And they call a foul on Helton. And 3:23 left to go here in this game that I'm sure the Hurricane wish was just over with
now. any consolation, it's a short trip.
Yeah.
Only a couple hours they got to go.
Jumper no good. Helton with the rebound. Back the other way come the Razor Sharks. Three is in and out, no good. Holmes with the rebound. Tries to get it to Helton. His layup and foul. And for the Rochester Razor Sharks, with 2:52 left to go here in the game, Rochester cruising to their first win of the year, 119-69 over the Hurricane. Back with the rest of the fourth next on the ESPN3. Back here live at the Blue Cross Arena, 119-69. Rochester with the lead over the Hurricanes.
Good to see people are still having fun in a 50-point basketball game.
Yeah, exactly. Well, they want to stay for fireworks, which is right after the game. Well, not directly after the game is over, but right around 10 o'clock. So, you know, people can hang out and watch fireworks or head to their party, whichever they want to do. And it has been a tradition in which the Razor Sharks do very well at starting off their season New Year's Eve.
Well, they definitely got off to a good start tonight after that first quarter.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. Mm-hmm. Which wasn't,
wasn't awful, but they weren't matching the energy level. And once they matched the energy level, the talent took over.
Yeah, a lot of scrappy play in that first quarter between the two teams in which, you know, the Hurricane looked like, you know, tied at 12, tied at 16, tied at, you know. And Rochester took a slight lead and then turned it on in the second and third quarters, which brings us to 121-69 here in the fourth with 2:36 left to play. Jump ball, Barry Holmes, and tipped away, picked up, Hodge, Ivy on him, knocked away, Ivy steals it, gets it back, Green, scoop layup is good.
Just unlucky there for John.
Yeah, good defense. He's in trouble now, tosses it way in the air, and it's coming right at us. .213 left to go here. Helton the inbound.
And a good, you know, a chance there for a little teaching point for John. You know, how to handle the double team.
Straight up, they're going to call foul. Ivy, they're going to say it was an active shooting, so he'll go to the free throw line. You can see here on the replay, Ivy keeping that ball. You know, it's the other thing, too, is knowing where a guy is behind you. That sense of awareness.
Especially with a little guy. They like to sneak up behind you and get you from behind.
It's old pickup basketball. You know.
Those are the only block shots I ever got. From behind. And if it was a big guy, he'd just call a foul. So
Free throw by Ivy's good. So John Ivy's played well today. Razor Sharks is a team. 3 out of 4 quarters is all you really need to come away with a win. Hodge for three. That's no good. Rebound, tipped around, picked up by Helton. He's harassed and able to get away with it. Ivy across midcourt to Holmes, over to Chichester. That's no good. Hodge on the sprint, 3-on-1. Boy, I tell you, the Razor Sharks got back on defense.
Yeah, good hustle by Chichester there to make it a tough play. And that, again, that's what you want to see. You want to still see guys, you know, playing hard in a 50-point game with a minute and a half left.
So all they got left here before this one's wrapped up. As the Razor Sharks will come away with the win. This is what they've been working for. When it came, we broke into practice in December. Middle of December, early part of December. 2 weeks, got their team ready. 2 weeks leading up into tonight. And Biggs can't get the free throw to go here.
And again, if you're Chautauqua, you know, get ready for the next game. You just chalk this up as, you know, they're better than us right now. And
you see, we
try to keep figuring out a way to try to get better.
Green to inbounds, and it's a minute 25 left to go before we wrap this up. Crossover. Knocking it away. And it's out of bounds. 1:15 left to play. John Ivory will join us in the post-game interview. Moving the ball around just a little bit. Kind of get some system going here. Hodge for three. Finally gets one to fall.
The best offensive possession of the second half.
Yeah. Moving the ball around. And yeah. Needed a lot more of that in order to keep this game close. The defensive breakdown again on a give and go. Simple basketball move.
And just not, they stopped moving their feet this whole fourth quarter. And
Hodge will take another three and feels good. That's two in a row for him. Ivy trying to hold it on. They want to harass him. He dribbles through it. Floater. Oh.
But
Chichester. Want to let you know I'm still going to score there. 25 seconds left to play. Hodge, three again. That's no good. Side rim. Shot clock turned off. Helton to hold it. And try to dribble it out for the 13 seconds that are left. So the Rochester Razor Sharks raise a banner for the championship of 2016 and start off the brand new year with a win in 2017. So the season has started. Rochester with a win. We'll talk with John Ivy a bit coming up next here on the Rochester Razor Sharks Broadcast Network. 128-75 Rochester wins. Where's the big lens? Where's the big lens? Deshaun, you need the big lens, son. Rochester Razor Sharks winning it tonight, 128-75. John Ivy joins us now here on the show. First of all, John, your first game out here, I know you're no stranger to the Blue Cross Arena. I know you played high school here in Rochester, at Broadport as well. Talk a bit about that at first coming out. You're wearing a professional jersey. You're out playing ball. What was that like for you today?
It was exciting. Most of all, it's a blessing. I thank God so much for giving me another opportunity to play ball. You know, if anybody knows me, you know, I tore my ACL 2 years ago. You know, ended my college career. I didn't even get to see my senior night. You know, and just to be back on the floor is just such a blessing. And then that in Rochester, you know, such a great place, a place I was born and raised, and I just love it, man. I can't even explain the feeling I had. I was excited to be out here.
Well, you know, I seen you in practice, always happy, always playing. I can see now why the journey back for you was a long one. So now I even feel even more happier for you. But talk a bit about tonight's game. You got a lot of burn. You got a lot of playing time. You got a chance to sort of feel what the competition's like. How do you stay focused for the next 3 months so this team can get end up back in the playoffs and try to go for another championship?
Well, just practice. You know, Coach Iverson's a great coach. We go at it in practice. You know, practice is not easy, and that's how we're going to stay ready and how I'm going to stay ready. You know, my teammates prepare me every day. You know, the vets, they on me. You know, Jerice Krause is like a big bro, man. Melvin Consul, of course, them two guys are, they harping on me all the time, and they just keep me focused and keep me level-headed.
Well, I got to say, you know, a lot of people cheering for you tonight, coming out to see you play. I know friends, family.
Yes, I thank you, all the fans. If you're listening, thank you so much. I appreciate everybody in Rochester. I love all you guys.
Well, I tell you what, man, long season to go. Great night for you. Congratulations.
Thank you, Tyree.
All right, no problem. John Ivy, makes me proud. I went to Broadport. Yeah. I went to Broadport too, baby.
Broadport alumni.
This is what we do, baby. This is the Golden Eagles. I love it. Rochester with a win, 128-75, as they take the first win of the year, try to put another banner up in the Blue Cross Arena. At your expense, for John Boone, thank you for joining us for today. And tune in all season long for Rochester Razor Sharks Broadcast Network for Razor Sharks Basketball. Good night, everybody, and Happy New Year.